Well, what I do is I'm using real microorganisms. They are like such as fungus and mold. They're not bacteria. Most of the people are thinking that they are bacteria, but this is like kind of a different concept. What I do is like these microorganisms are living in the nature, but we do not see them with our naked eye. So first of all, I'm making them visible to our eyes, and they're making themselves visible with their own characteristics and their color, and then their form. And then after that, I'm just creating the maps, and I apply, like, each country has like one of those microbes, and then they're just creating their own territories. And then sometimes they're creating borders between each of them, because what happens is, like, I'm taking these guys from the nature and then putting them inside of a petri dish. So the petri dish is like very restricted about like everything. The space is restricted, the food sources are restricted, so I'm just taking them from the nature and then putting them into this artificial environment, and that makes them a little bit angry. So they're just trying to survive in that little tiny artificial environment. And then when they're growing and then when they're establishing their own territories, they're just creating borders, distinctive forms. It's like, you know, I'm just finding them a little bit related to us, to human beings. So they are actually metaphorically referring to human condition and what's happening in our world. So that's why I'm like creating maps actually. So each of the country has one different microorganism. So in the video work actually, what I did was I placed like more aggressive microbes into the developed countries and then a little bit more less aggressive kinds for the developing countries. So that actually a little bit more created that tension and then political conditions and what's happening in our world right now. But this is their own natural color. That's their own forms. And on the video, you're gonna see that actually lots of condensation is happening because there are like lots of biological activities are happening. Years I was working in research labs, so we were like researching these microbes and how they live in the nature, like in a harmony, and then, you know, sometimes that harmony is like unbalanced, and then these microbes are like killing the trees and making damage to the forest and so on. So when I was working with these microorganisms like every day, and then one day I was just sitting there, and then during that time actually I was doing my second degree in art, and then one day I was like looking to those things, like very colorful, and then they're like, you know, very different forms. And I just looked at the petri dish and I said, you know, I have to just somehow combine what I know in my past, like in my scientific background, and then what I know now, like with my art practice. And then, you know, this is what I ended up like doing. So this is called bio art, actually. So what happens is bio art is like you have to use something living in your art form, in your art practice. So then it's called bio art. So there are some other artists doing, you know, bio artwork. What happens is actually, there are other artists doing this scientific bio art kind of artwork, but, you know, some of them, like, they're just taking the scientific material from the, you know, the lab, scientific labs, and then they're just using, because they look visually compelling. But what I wanted to bring to my artwork is actually like a different layer from, you know, political approaches and then, you know, human condition and what's happening in our world. So I just wanted to combine all of the things. Because what happens is like if I just use only scientific material, it is not going to be that interesting for the scientific people who visits the gallery and see my work. But I just wanted to make some interesting things for the scientists and also for the, you know, normal people who just come to the galleries and then look for the work. And then these are my living paint, let's say. So I kind of see myself as like a painter, but my things are like alive. So that's the difference.